Hello traders, I'm Luke from Discipline Trader. This video is part of the Trading Basics series, and in this one we are looking at how to get and use a charting platform. I will be going through the basic functionality of the platform, and will add a contents with time links in the description below if you want to skip to a particular part at any time. I will be using MetaTrader 4, as I think this is the best platform for new traders, and most brokers offer this platform with their accounts. To download MetaTrader 4, you can go directly to metatrader4.com and download it from there. Alternatively, you can find a broker that offers the platform and sign up for a real or demo account with them. I know Active Trades and IG offer MT4 for both their real and demo accounts. Just go to their websites and follow the instructions to get it installed. Once that's done and you've opened the platform, it will ask for login details for your real or demo account if you have them. Alternatively, there should be an option to set up a new account if you don't already have one. As you can see here, I have downloaded this platform through IG and it will allow me to open a real or demo account. All I do is complete the forms and hit next. Once you've done that and logged in, you should see the bars in the bottom right corner go green to show that you are connected to the live price feed. Now you have the platform installed and opened, the next thing I will go over is how to change the chart options. As you can see on my platform, I have a range bar chart with a green and black colour scheme. The first thing I want to change is the chart type to a candlestick chart. I can do this by either clicking the chart and then clicking the candlestick button, or I can right click on the chart, go to properties, then click the common tab and select candlesticks, then press OK. The next thing I want to change is the colour scheme of the chart. Again, to do this, right click on the chart and go to properties, then go to the colours tab. Here you will be presented with a list of items and their corresponding colours. You can simply choose the colour you want from the drop down menu. I want a white background, black foreground, no grid, red and green candles with a black outline. You can play around with these settings as much as you need to get the charts just how you want them. There are a few ways to read what price the market is currently trading at. The first is to just look at the price axis on the chart and the current trading price will be highlighted. Alternatively, you can use the market watch window as this shows the bid and ask prices for all the markets on the list. If the window isn't showing, you can simply click the market watch button and this will appear. Lastly, you can show the one-click trading buttons and you will be able to see the bid and ask price on each chart. To do this, simply click the small black arrow in the top left corner of each chart. If you want to hide them again, simply press the arrow again. MT4 gives you the ability to make chart templates to save the settings you have made for your charts. For example, you will see if I open a new chart, the settings revert back before we made the changes. So to save the chart settings you want, you need to make a template. To do this, click on the chart where you have made the setting amendments, then right-click on the chart, go to Template, and press Save Template. You can call this anything you like. I'm going to call this Day Trading. Then when I open a new chart, I can simply right-click on it, go to Template, then click Day Trading, and it will use the settings I have saved. You can also go to the Template menu by using the button on the quick bar at the top of the platform. A little tip when saving your template. If you call your template default, it will open all new charts with these settings from here on. For example, I will save these chart settings as a new template called default, and when I open a new chart this time, it automatically uses those settings. To open a chart of a different market, we need the market watch window again. Again, if this isn't already open, you can open it by clicking the market watch button on the quick bar at the top of the platform. This window shows a long list of all the markets we can look at. Simply right-click on the market you want to look at and press Chart Window and a chart will open. If the market you are looking for isn't on the list, you may need to add it. For example, I want to add the FTSE 100 to my list. So to do this, I need to right-click on the Market Watch window and press Symbols. You can then look through the different market categories and show or hide any market you like. I'm going to add the FTSE 100, so I'm going to go into the Indices category, click FTSE 100 and press Show, then Close. Now the FTSE 100 will be in my market watch window. To change the time frame of a chart, we can either right click on it and go to time frames, then select the time frame we want to view, or we can use the time frame quick bar at the top of the platform to quickly choose a different time frame. All you do is click the chart you want to change and then click the time frame button you want. You can also zoom in and zoom out on a chart. Again, this can be done by either right clicking on the chart and then pressing either zoom in or zoom out, or you can use the zoom quick bar buttons at the top of the platform. To scroll back on a chart, you simply left click on the chart, hold and drag it across to move backwards. You may notice that the chart keeps jumping back to the present time, and this happens every time the current price changes. To turn this feature off so you can scroll back without being interrupted by the price changes, simply press the button with two axes and a little green play button. If you want to turn this feature back on, simply press the button again. To use drawing tools on a chart, you simply use the quick bar at the top of the platform. Just select which tool you want to use and then start adding them to your chart. You can change the settings of the drawing by double clicking on them on the chart so that two little boxes appear at either side of the drawing. Then you can right click on it and press settings. To delete a drawing, just double click on it and then hit delete on your keyboard or right click and press delete. You can add other drawing tools to the quick bar by right clicking on the quick bar and pressing customize. You can then look through the list and add tools to the quick bar. You can also remove any tools that you don't want. You can measure the price change from two points by using the crosshair cursor. Select it from the drawing tools quick bar and simply left click on your chart and drag to where you want to measure to. You'll be shown three numbers. The first is how many candles you have measured over. The second is the pip change with one decimal place. So for example, if the middle number shows 504, that is a change of 50.4 pips. And the last number is the price at which your cursor is currently pointing at. To add indicators to your chart, simply click the chart you want to add an indicator to, and then go to Insert at the top of the platform, and then click Indicators. You will then see a list of different indicators you can add to your chart. To change the indicator settings or remove it from your chart, right click on the chart and go to Indicator List. You can then select which indicator you want to change and either edit the settings or delete it completely from the chart. You can resize any chart by simply dragging one of the sides or corners to the size you want. MetaTrader 4 does have an inbuilt function to arrange the charts for you. Simply go to the Window menu at the top of the platform and choose from either Tile Windows, Cascade Windows, Tile Horizontally, or Tile Vertically. You will also see a tab along the bottom of the chart window for each chart window you have open. If you are looking at the charts in full screen, you can toggle through the chart windows using these tabs. If you want to have the charts open over two monitors, press the Restore Down button in the top right corner of the platform and drag it over the two monitors. You can then manually arrange the charts over the two monitors. You can enter a trade by clicking the New Order button on the quick bar at the top of the platform. A little dialog box will open asking for more details about the position you want to open. You simply select the market you want to trade from the drop-down, set the position size in the volume box, set a take profit level and a stop level if you want to, if not, leave this blank, and lastly choose what order type you want to use. Then press the buy or sell button to execute the order. You can also quickly enter a trade by using the one-click trade buttons we looked at earlier. To turn them on, go to Tools on the quick bar at the top of the platform, then press Options. Then check One-Click Trading. Agree to the terms if you are happy and press OK. The buttons will then be added to your chart. To make them visible, simply click the small black arrow in the top left corner of each chart and they will appear. To use them, simply enter the position size you want in the little box and either click Buy or Sell and your trade will be executed straight away. Any open trade you have will be displayed in the terminal window at the bottom of your platform. If this window isn't open, simply press the Terminal Window button on the quick bar at the top of the platform. Then press the Trade tab on the terminal window and your trades will be displayed there. To close a trade immediately, you can click the little cross at the far right side of the trade entry in the terminal window. You can also close a trade by setting a stop loss level or a take profit level. To add either of these levels to your trade, double-click the box for either on the trade entry in the terminal window and a dialog box will open. Then simply enter the level you want each to be at and press modify. These levels will then be shown on your chart. You can view all your past completed trades by clicking on the Account History tab in the terminal window. It will show you the order number, time, date, trade direction, position size, market traded, price you entered, stop loss level and take profit level if set, date and time you closed the position, the price you closed the position, any swap amendments, and the profit and loss for the trade. I know some traders will be asking about the other charting platforms out there. There are other charting platforms available other than MT4, such as Pro Real Time, NinjaTrader, eSignal, TradeStation, to name a few. But the reason I've used MT4 here is because I think it's a great place to start for new traders. And it's free. It has all the features you need and is offered by the majority of brokers. It's very easy to use and to get to grips with. The last thing you want is a confusing platform when you're trying to learn how to trade. That wraps up this video on using a charting platform. I hope you have found it useful. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to drop a like on it. If you have any questions or want me to cover any other topics in future videos, please let me know in the comments below. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. I will be continuing this Trading Basics series to provide new traders with all the knowledge they need to get started. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you all have a good trading week.